night flight echoes of a lost time. In this world we'll shine. A rare reborn, our destiny calls. Through the trials we stand tall. From the ashes we ignite. With hope and valor we'll fight. Facing primals, we've wrapped untamed. Orcia's fate must be reclaimed. Together we stand as one, will prevail. In this epic tale we will not fail. Guided by the crystal's light, through the darkness we take flight. Echoes of a lost time, in this world we'll shine. A realm reborn, our destiny calls. Through the trials we stand tall. From the ashes we ignite. With hope and valor we'll fight. Through the fields of Vanillin, to the forests of Redenia, in the peaks of Kurthus, and the shores of Lenosia. We'll unite our strength, our sins entwined, for Orcia, our fates aligned. Marching onward, against the Empire's might, in the face of Gollum, of whom we'll lose sight. With the science by our side, we stand as one, till the Empire falls, our fight's not done. A realm reborn, our destiny calls. The trials we stand tall. From the ashes we ignite. With hope and valor we'll fight. In the realm reborn, our journey begins. With every challenge we'll face and win. Bound by the crystal, our spirits soar. In Orcia, forevermore.
Cambridge. Be at ease, everyone. Your ether will soon be replenished. Suffer no interference. Disappear.
Deploying drone.
Do not be afraid. Death is not the end.
In reality? Has she lost control of the power? Sting! Listen to me! I understand. I do. And I know that you won't be swayed from your course. There's truly no other way to resolve this. Then face me, not as a machine, but as the real you. desire, and I will not fail. I can't bear to lose them. Not again! I feel your pain as if it were my own. I think I know you. All of you. How can you say that to me now? It's over, Steen. We will stop you. No! I won't let you! I can't! I will protect my people's happiness! Leave that burden with us now! We will bear it in your stead! Sveen! Your voice reached me, Lamachi.
Is it really you?
No, only in part. My memories as a living person are gone. I've been remade from those I had as an endless. However, I cannot remain long, for the Meso Terminal will soon cease to function. Once you wanted to know me, Lamachi. Let my last act be to give an honest accounting. I am, above all, sorry for the suffering I've caused your people and mine. I am ultimately powerless against the inevitable, unable to do aught but visit harm upon the innocent. I am, in the end, a pitiful, selfish creature, one that should never have been created.
Thank you.
Our nations are worlds apart, but they feel so close. Who knows what we could have accomplished had we walked together towards a shared future. And yet, it could never be so. We each had our own to protect.
If only I had met you when I was still alive, then perhaps. But it's no use dwelling upon a miracle that didn't happen. Still, if there's one thing I hope you'll believe, it is this. Brief though it was, I treasured our time together. It pains me to think that its memory will disappear along with me. I know I have no right to ask this of you, but when I'm gone, my people, will you?
We'll take care of them. Don't worry. And we will never forget the Endless. Neither them, nor the time we spent with you. So be free of your burdens, Sveen. And sleep well.
I will. Thank you. Farewell, my beloved Alexandria.
So it was that the Meso-Terminal fell dark, and the Endless departed for Oblivion's embrace. Their resplendent paradise was no more, as the memory sustaining it faded with the golden light. Even so, In a way, they live on. This I felt with conviction as I basked in the glow of a new dawn. All this pain inside of me, don't know where it starts or when it'll end. Try to tame the agony as I close my eyes and scream to the wind. Look around and find me standing all alone. Look again, we're standing there. Cause the storm is taking everything. It remains to be seen how interdimensional fusion may have affected other reflections. Krile's parents spoke of the power's capacity for both good and evil. I cannot help but wonder how Sveen's deeds will be remembered by those they touched. The key that started it all was entrusted to the adventurer. Such an artifact certainly lies within the Scion's realm of expertise, and no objection was raised to their retaining it for research. By order of Vau Kona, the Skydeep Cenote was placed under the strict watch of the Landsguard. With the mighty Bakul Jaja among their number, they shall not want for strength, even in Soralja's absence. Upon learning of their queen's passing, the people of Alexandria mourned and wept. Having devoted herself to sparing them sorrow, the sight might well have moved Sveen to tears. However, with Wuklamad carrying on her legacy, I have faith that her subjects will know joy once more. As anticipated, the news that young Gululja had succeeded his father as king was greeted with trepidation. Reception was also mixed when Wuklamad came forward to name herself as the boy's guardian. But the people were mollified to learn that Everkeep systems remained operational, and there would be no impact on their lives. One day, when he is older, Gululja will decide for himself what manner of ruler he will be. Till that day and beyond, may the path of the young king be illuminated by the love of family.
You love me, it's waking up.
Meanwhile, in Tulliola, the people came together to hail their new Dawn Servant's great victory. Having honored those they lost, they turned their attention to a brighter future and celebrated for 3 days and nights. Not everything had been resolved, though. Those who had spent 30 years in the Dome struggled to resume their former lives. This and a host of other challenges remained. As the new Dawn Servants continue to lead with strength and wisdom, the people may be assured that peace will endure.
Thank you. Standing here, not a star in the sky to guide me tonight. Live for lost in fear, deep in darkness, drown my cries. All this pain inside of me, don't know where it starts or when it'll end. Try to tame the agony as I close my eyes and scream to the wind. Look around and find me standing.
I'm sorry, we haven't been able to talk properly. Oh, between the reconstruction work and Papa's funeral, I've hardly had time to breathe. But at long last, oh, there's a lull in my duties. You've done more for us than we could ever hope to repay. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
When we left the Orsiak behind to take part in the contest, none of us could have predicted what complications would follow. You truly have a knack for finding trouble, my friend. And you wouldn't have it any other way.
So what's next for you? Assuming you're still set on leaving the Gleaner's life behind?
I'm off to fulfill my mother's dream, of course. Like she had intended, I'll embark on a journey in search of the unknown. She's sure to enjoy my stories when we meet again in the Ethereal Sea.
Well, well, sounds like a plan. But will you have the coin to get by?
I may no longer be a Gleaner, but I still have contacts in Charlion. Contacts with deep pockets. Always eager to pay for information on new or rare species.
You've got it all worked out. And what of you? Any new adventures in the offing? Regardless, until you're ready to leave, you're our guest here in Tulijolal.
And this time, I won't pester you to take up a post. By now, I know you well enough to know you can't stay in one place. No more than you can ignore the plight of those in need. Your path will always lead you elsewhere, and you'll continue walking it. Isn't that so?
An adventurer to the marrow you are. What is it exactly that spurs you on?
Thank you.